on KFOG San Francisco, San Jose.
San Francisco, byernes by i bilernes land. Men San Francisco er anderledes. Francisco er ikke bare biler. Byen har masser af offentlige transportmidler. Det er veludbygget, billigt og rent. Sporvogne fra forstædernes gader kører ned i dybet som metro i City. Trolleybusserne kanter sig vej gennem virvaret af ledninger, og i de stejle gader er der de berømte cable cars. Men oven i det hele er der noget, der kan gøre enhver sporvognsentusiast helt elektrisk. Midt i City er byens gamle sporvogne genoplivet som et højst konkurrencedygtigt tilbud i trafikmylderet.
They are a real pleasure to be on. There's great craftsmanship in the bus on the streetcars. There's a feeling of great camaraderie amongst people and the operators. It's a much more pleasurable ride than on buses. You'll find San Franciscans, when given the option of traveling either by bus or by the historic streetcars, will inevitably take the historic car.
Egentlig skulle de gamle streetcars bare have været en parentes i starten af 1980'erne. Da byens kabelcars skulle renoveres, fik de smukke gamle sporvogne en chance som midlertidig turistattraktion. Men de skulle vise sig at kunne mere end det.
Well, we found out, and rather almost really by accident, was that the people here in San Francisco, both our daily commuters and tourists alike, are very much interested in riding these cars. It went into service originally in 1983 as a historic trolley festival while we were renovating the cable car system, which was down for a year and a half.
Så da cable cars var på gaden igen, var det ikke de gamle sporvogne, der røg retur i remisen. Det var i stedet buslinje 8, der havde tabt kampen om passagererne.
If you should give a good advice to the Copenhagen Muni system, is that to rebuild a streetcar line?
Well, you know, I would tell them this. It's been our experience that it was more than profitable. It increased the public's awareness here of public transportation. It increased the public's awareness of our municipal pride, and it has enhanced the city many times more than it's cost us. So I would say yes, it's something you should look at very seriously.
I wish you guys would get those Copenhagen streetcars behind the wall in Copenhagen out on the street again, because you'll get that many more people riding them, and they'll pay themselves off in no time, even after putting all the track and rail and everything back in again.
San Francisco's gamle sporvognspark tæller vogne ikke alene fra amerikanske byer, men fra hele verden.
Venice.
The fleet that we run now on the F Market Line are what are called PCC cars, President's Conference cars, that were built in the 1930s and 40s. Those are the regular service cars, but we also have historic cars that date back into the 19th century. And they come not only from the United States, but from literally all over the world. We have cars from Europe, from Italy and England. And we have cars from Russia, we have cars from Japan and Australia, and we're always on the lookout for other historic cars that we can run and show off in the city.
Så hvis HT i Danmark ikke selv vil sende sin gamle sporvogn ud i de københavnske gader, så vil San Francisco gerne have dem.
Denmark would be an added jewel to our fleet. Oh, in the sky, what is love?